What a pity that it's the outrageous behaviour of a small number of pitiable louts on the terraces that will make the headlines. And some will suggest that it was all provoked by the behaviour of one or two players, particularly the scorer of a hat-trick, John Aldridge, and even the referee, only doing his job after all. Well, that's far too glib an explanation of a major social problem. Those morons don't need a reason.
Well, the last visitors to win at the Manor Ground were Gillingham on March the 13th. Oxford have gone 17 home games without defeat since then. And indeed, in the second division overall this season, Oxford have lost only one. That was at Manchester City. But Leeds put a bomb underneath them in the first half here. Can they capitalise in the second, I wonder? Played forward by Greater Ritchie. And now it's Lorimer. Met by Shotton and up by Dickinson for Ritchie. Rhodes Brown. Dickinson again. Lorimer. Right. Was out. Again, and Hebbard to float one. Hamilton's there at the far post. 2-2. A simple enough goal. Hebbard involved in the build-up. The ball chipped across to the far post, and Billy Hamilton came in to score his 14th of the season for Oxford. That puts him level with Aldridge, but more important, it puts Oxford level on the day. That was Briggs. Now Linegan. And here's Brock. And Aldridge is coming in. It's there. 3-2. Aldridge scores for Oxford. And they've come from 2-0 behind to take the lead. And in all honesty, Aldridge gets double the credit for that goal. Because he was part of the build-up. He got the ball wide to Brock. He made his way to the far post. Brock's cross was perfect, Aldridge's header was just as good, and with his 15th goal of the season, the top scorer in Division 2 makes it Oxford 3, Leeds United 2. And the famous slope on the Manor Ground comes to Oxford's aid again. They started the second half 2-1 down, and they've got two goals in double quick time. And the partnership we spotlighted at the start is on target again. John Aldridge and Billy Hamilton. Hebbard forward. Irwin. Langan to Brock. Driven forward for Billy Hamilton. And now Sheridan for Leeds. The early ball again, looking for Wright. Shotton is the defender. And here's Hebbard. Rhodes Brown on the left wing. his crossing. Dickinson wasn't sure. Hamilton's there. And Linnigan it was who held Dickinson out. As Hamilton threatened to pounce on the error, Brock with the corner. And Hamilton, oh, mistake! And Briggs. Rhodes Brown with the cross. Hamilton's in there again, and Aldridge almost got a foot to it. How well they work together, those two. Hamilton headed it down, and Aldridge was within a foot or so of getting it in. Dickinson. Hebbard was in the way. Hamilton. Oh, it's Aldridge. He's clean through. He's got past the goalkeeper. Aldridge, 4-2. What a game this is. Aldridge gets his second. Billy Hamilton working so well with Aldridge. And once he put him through the middle, Aldridge knew what to do. Round the goalkeeper. A typical striker's goal, that. And Oxford now have taken their total of goals for the season to 49. And here's Wright for Leeds. On a hat-trick. Hamilton won't mind that. And Leeds United want to make a substitution. Mark Gavin, who is a winger, is going to come on. And Scott Sellers is the player going off. Tussling with Rhodes Brown. Oh, I say, that's Aldridge and Lorimer. And Aldridge's reaction there left Lorimer holding his face. I never touched him, says Aldridge. You could see him say that. Now, the referee's got to take a view on this as to what really happened there. No doubt about the two players involved, Lorimer and Aldridge. Lorimer claiming that he was struck in the face, it would appear. And Lorimer still showing his anger. And he looks as though he's being booked as well. And has he sent Peter Lorimer off? He's sent Peter Lorimer off. He looks mystified. Aldridge has been booked, but Peter Lorimer, the veteran player of Leeds United, 22 years in the Football League, and I've never seen him in that sort of trouble before. He appears to have got the worst of it physically with a blow on the lip, but he's been sent off the pitch. Whether that's for his part in the incident initially, or whether he said something to the referee afterwards in the heat of the moment, it's difficult to say from here. Aldridge. A chance for him again. Oh, I say. They call him the second division Ian Rush. It doesn't look unlike him actually, but my word, he knows where the goal is, just the same as the Liverpool striker. Actually, he was born in Liverpool, John Aldridge. And the Leeds supporters have lost their heads completely now. Sad memories of a minority letting Leeds down in the past, and they've done so again. Jim Smith sharing the concern of everybody else in the ground, because there does seem to be a danger now in football that crowds are going to start getting matches either abandoned or replayed, and we don't want that. Brock. Aldridge! A hat-trick! And 17 goals this season. How do you stop John Aldridge? And when you've got a man who can cross the ball like Kevin Brock, and you've got a player that can feed on chances like Aldridge, No wonder you lead the second division only a year after winning the third. Oxford United 5, Leeds United 2. Brock the supplier again, but the man making the headlines here today, John Aldridge with 3 goals, and he's in the middle again now as Hamilton gets possession. And Oxford United confirm their position at the top of the second division by winning 5-2 after being 2 goals behind. An afternoon packed with incident here at the Manor Ground. Billy Hamilton got the goal just after half-time that turned the match, but it was his striking partner John Aldridge who got the next 3 that clinched the points for Oxford. Leeds had Lorimer sent off, and there was a little bit of crowd disturbance too, but in second division terms, there's no holding Oxford. They've scored 50 goals this season, and they're on course for Division 1.
And isn't that Oxford United success story splendid? No one enjoys or deserves it more than Jim Smith. But what a pity that it's the outrageous behaviour of a small number of pitiable louts on the terraces that'll make the headlines. And some will suggest that it was all provoked by the behaviour of one or two players, particularly the scorer of a hat-trick, John Aldridge, and even the referee, only doing his job after all. Well, that's far too glib an explanation of a major social problem. Those morons don't need a reason. But in retrospect, Peter Lorimer will feel he was unlucky to be sent off. But he should know by now, whatever the provocation, not to tempt Providence by over-vigorous protest. Lorimer tricked and tackled his way past Rhodes Brown and then tried something similar on Aldridge with a touch of shirt and arm pulling to help. Aldridge's reaction, a flinging back of arm and hand, does make contact, but was not the knockout blow we might be led to think. But again, a splendid match in the main, plenty to enjoy from both sides, leaving Oxford United a little nearer making history.
But in retrospect, Peter Lorimer will feel he was unlucky to be sent off. But he should know by now, whatever the provocation, not to tempt Providence by over-vigorous protest. Lorimer tricked and tackled his way past Rhodes Brown, and then tried something similar on Aldridge with a touch of shirt and arm pulling to help. Aldridge's reaction, flinging back of arm and hand, does make contact, but was not the knockout blow we might be led to think. But again, a splendid match in the main, plenty to enjoy from both sides, leaving Oxford United a little nearer making history.